fiery horse with the speed of light, the cloud of dust, and a hearty hi-yo, Silver, the Lone Ranger. Secret organization called the Legion of the Black Arrow sprang up in the western United States. Its members were to be found everywhere, defying the law or using the law for their own purposes, working toward the ultimate goal of revolt and the foundation of a despotic empire. It was the masked rider of the plains that led the fight against this band of outlaws and traitors, and for once his great strength and courage, his daring and resourcefulness were taxed to the utmost in the cause of democracy. Return with us now to those thrilling days when the West was young. From out of the past come the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse Silver. The Lone Ranger rides again.
Come on, Silver! We're on the trail of the Black Arrow! Come on, Silver! Away!
The Lone Ranger had discovered a plot directed by the Black Arrow Legion, summoned the sheriff and his posse to capture the bad men after a sharp battle. Then the prisoners were herded back to town by the sheriff's deputies, while the ranger and the sheriff stayed behind to look for signs of any Black Arrow men who might have escaped. But suddenly, the sheriff pulled a gun on the masked man and snarled,
"Ice your hands high, masked man. Make one move and I pull the trigger pronto."
"Sheriff, are you crazy?"
"No, I ain't. I had to string along when the posse was around. I even had to let the boys get captured. But I was just waiting for a chance when the two of us might be alone. Mister, in case you want to know, I wear a tattoo mark myself."
"You?"
"Yeah. You didn't figure I was a member of the Black Arrow, did you?"
That's it."
"Yeah. Not one of my deputies know it. But I'm telling you for a reason.
The Legion of the Black Arrow can't win."
"You think it matters because that posse is putting the gang in jail? Only two of them are Black Arrow members. The rest were just hired special for the job. They don't matter a coyote's howl to us. But you do. You matter plenty."
"The army will locate your hideout."
"Not a chance. It's hid away up in the mountains, high above..." "No, you don't. Pretty smart hombre, huh?"
"That depends. What are your plans for me?"
"Oh, we got big plans for you, mister. You'll stay alive, savvy? You'll stay alive, but you'll be our prisoner. We'll get information out of you if we have to torture you to drag it out. We'll take your mask off and find out who you are. And then we'll put that mask on one of our own men to send him out in your place. That ought to work out pretty good, seeing that nobody ever saw you unmasked, huh?"
"You talk big, Sheriff. Or should I say, ex-sheriff?"
"Suit yourself, mister. But we've powwowed long enough. Time to move along."
"You've got the drop on me."
"Which same I aim to keep."
"It only takes one bullet. Why don't you shoot?"
"Got plenty of nerve, haven't you? I know, masked man. We got orders to find out what's under your mask."
"You'll never make me take off my mask."
"No? Well, we'll see about that. Now do just what I tell you. Keep your right hand high. Unbuckle your gun belt with your left. Move it slow."
"My left hand?"
"No tricks. You may have a draw like lightning, but this gun's already aimed and the hammer is cocked. Go ahead. Unhitch that belt. So. Now, slide the belt off the saddle and let it drop. Well, I feel better now with your guns on the ground. I didn't figure you'd give in so easy. I always heard the Lone Ranger was a tough hombre.
What's the next move, Sheriff?
That mask. Take it off.
You'll have to make me...
Take it off! Keno, mister. There ain't nobody around to stop me from shooting you.
Except your orders?
I can forget my orders. I can say I had to shoot.
You're not bluffing me, Sheriff.
I ain't bluffing. You're too all-fired calm to suit me. It's getting under my skin. Now take off that mask or I'll... What's that?
Sounded like a bird.
Yeah, a night bird. Yeah. Better do it pronto, Mask Man. I'll wake up more than one bird if I have to shoot. I'm giving you till I count three. One, two...
Keep it, Tommy!
What the...
Pronto!
Get up, boss! Get past him!
Kimasabi, him right way. We go after him, huh?
No, Tonto.
But we catch him easy.
No, let him go. I want him to lead us to the men higher up.
Oh. Tonto's happy now.
You heard the talk between us?
Not right. Me walk scout up plenty slow till we get close. Him Black Arrow, huh?
Yes, Tonto. Rather than capture him now, it's better for us to follow his trail. Let him get a good head start so he doesn't suspect we'll be after him.
You not hurt?
No, not touched. He had his gun right on me, too. But I dropped to one side of the saddle when you came in.
You hear me give bird call, huh?
Yes. I'll get my gun belt.
It plenty good, Neely Posse. Come back to you.
If you hadn't, I might have been done for. But I heard you close by, and the sheriff didn't.
And what we do now?
Well, we'll wait till morning, Kimosabe. And we'll pick up Sheriff Brady's trail and get after him.
Not good. Me fix campfire.
When dawn came, the Lone Ranger and Tonto had to change their plans about setting out at once after the sheriff. For while their horses were being saddled...
Steady, Silver. Steady, old boy.
Scout already. What matters, Silver?
Stand still, old fella. The saddle... Silver, what's the matter with your leg?
Oh, him lame.
Now let me see, old fella.
Look, there.
A bullet burned along his leg, Tonto. One of Brady's shots must have hit him.
Hit bad?
Oh, just glanced off the bone. That leg will be stiff for several days. We can't trail Brady now, Tonto. We'll have to wait.
Howdy, Torlock. Got here fast as I could.
Where's the masked man, Brady?
Well, I...
Speak up. You were given definite orders about the Lone Ranger.
They didn't work out.
You failed.
Well, it wasn't my fault. I stayed behind the posse like it was arranged for me to do. I was alone with the masked man. Had the drop on him.
Well?
That doggone redskin part of his come hightailing out of the woods. I had to vamoose fast.
Did you come straight here?
Why, sure.
And you were a sheriff.
Huh?
Members of the Black Arrow Legion should be smarter than that, Brady. You know, I've got a good mind...
Hey, don't pull your gun on me. What'd I do?
You neglected to cover your trail. Suppose the masked man and the Indian are after you.
Why, they... No, they can't be. It was dark. They couldn't follow a trail. Besides, I've been watching the back track. There's no sign of them.
All right, Brady. It's too late for talk.
Yeah. What's my orders?
Head for Montana.
Montana?
You'll go to Virginia City to the Silver Lode Bar. There'll be a man dressed in black boots, black trousers, black braid coat. He'll have a red string tie. The left-hand corner of the bar.
What's his handle?
You'll learn his name later. You'll identify yourself to him in the usual way.
I'm savvy.
Frequent the bar until you meet him.
Keno, I'll head that way right now.
Yeah, mister, name your poison. You look almighty dusty.
I've been traveling far. Give me two fingers straight.
Two fingers. There you are. Two fingers.
Leave the bottle.
Sure thing. I'll be around if you want me. Just holler.
Howdy, stranger. I don't recollect seeing you around, Helena.
I just got in.
What's your handle?
My name is Brady.
Brady, huh? You always stand at the left-hand corner of the bar?
I do when it's a Silver Lode Bar.
Mm-hmm. Where you hail from?
Mister, I came so fast it's hard to say.
How fast?
Fast as an arrow.
An arrow? Any particular color?
Yeah, mister. Black.
That's so. You're wearing a wristlet, Brady, on your left wrist.
How are you?
You got something under it?
Like this? I have, mister. The same.
A black arrow tattooed. But you made good time, Brady. Get to your horse. Meet me at the first creek on the trail to Virginia City. We can talk there.
Hello. I'm here, Brady. Waiting for you.
I was sent here by the Legion.
My name's Craddock. I've been expecting you.
I wasn't told what's stirring, Craddock.
Trouble is stirring, Brady. Trouble for the Black Arrow. Now listen close.
Shoot.
There's a meeting due to take place soon in Helena. A meeting to decide whether the territory of Montana stays a territory or puts in a request to the United States government to become a state.
What? If Montana gets into the Union, it's going to be bad for us.
The Black Arrow's got to make sure that doesn't happen. Savvy?
Yeah. What's the scheme?
That depends, Brady. There are six more delegates besides me. They've been appointed by meetings all over Montana to come to Helena and decide the matter.
You? You're a delegate?
Well, sure. Why not?
But you're a Black Arrow man.
The gents who made me a delegate don't know that.
Oh, I get it.
There's two other delegates besides me who are going to vote against becoming a state. They're honest. I just convinced them by talking.
Three, huh? That still leaves four.
Keno. And in this case, the majority wins. Unless we do something to get a majority, the chances are mighty good that Montana becomes a state. And that's just what the leader of the Black Arrow doesn't want. Savvy?
Yeah. How about shooting?
Too much talk. These zombies are delegates.
Oh.
I tried talking to them. That was no good. So the next step is scaring them. The first one to tackle is a gent named Donald. Bill Donald. He and his wife are camping out in a covered wagon near South Gap Pass.
That's the way I came into town.
We can start their way now. Shouldn't take as long, and it's dark. Plenty dark.
Get up, get up.
Bill Donald.
Huh? Hey, what's that?
The rider's coming up the trail from the south.
Yeah, I can just make him out in the firelight. Gosh, a mighty Sarah. Look at that white horse the big fella's riding. Did you ever see such a horse?
Hello.
Howdy.
Welcome, stranger.
Hello there. Looking for a man riding a star with a white blade in his left foreleg. I wonder if you've seen him.
I was in town all day, mister.
How about you, ma'am? We believe he took this trail.
Ah, trail plenty old, but we find it.
Why, yes, mister, I do remember a horse answering that description. He passed this afternoon. As I recollect, the man had a heavy mustache.
That sounds like Brady.
He's the law after him. You alone him?
Not exactly, but...
You sorry.
Otto, what is...
Look out!
Bill!
Blaze, it's an arrow. Somebody shot an arrow right into our wagon.
Otto, that's a Black Arrow. We'll be back, mister.
Come on, Silver.
Come on, Scout. They're going after him. Bill, what in the world can it mean? What's so particular about a Black Arrow?
Well, Silver! Away!
The curtain falls on the first act of our Lone Ranger story. Before the next exciting scenes, please permit us to pause for just a few moments.
Now to continue our story. When a Black Arrow flew through the air and struck Bill Donald's wagon, the Lone Ranger and Tonto dashed off into the darkness in the direction it had come from.
Arrow come from this way.
What's the trail, Tonto?
He not see anything.
Right up, stop.
Oh, Oscar. Oh,
steady,
oh,
Silver. Oh. The cliff, Kimosabe. I can't see the top.
It's plenty steep. Fellow who shoot the arrow, get way, huh?
Yes, Tonto. We're heading back to the covered wagon. I want to have another talk with Donald. Come on, Silver.
Two men that went after him,
Hans. Howdy. Getting any sign of who shot this arrow, mister?
It was shot from the top of the cliff, Donald. Whoever was up there hurried away.
Well, hop off your horse, stranger. You too, Injun. I want you to meet Jeff Hansen, a friend of mine.
Glad to know you, Hansen.
Hi. Bill was telling me about you. He said, well, I'll be a jayhawk. Donald, this hombre's masked.
What's that?
Why, so he is. Reckon his hat cast a shadow before.
Masked, huh? What are you, an outlaw?
I'm not outlaw.
That's enough out of you, Injun. You two better vamoose before I start spitting lead.
You're making a mistake, Hanson. We're friends.
Donald, are you loco? You let Miss Gent hoodwink you? For all you know, maybe he had something to do with that black arrow.
Now, hold on, Jeff. Something about this hombre. Well, I trust him. We're all going to be friends.
What does that arrow mean to you?
The arrow don't mean a doggone thing to me, mister. There was a note attached to it. I savvy that, all right. Here it is.
Change your vote.
That's all it says.
Your vote on what?
You mean you don't know? I reckon you did come a long way, then. Why, Bill Donovan, me are delegates to the meeting in Helena.
Meeting?
That's it, Masked Man. There are 7 men in town here to vote on whether Montana should apply for admission to the Union as a state. That's what the fuss is all about.
The votes are shaping up 4 in favor and 3 against.
I see. Miss Arrow is a threat to change your vote and make it against statehood. Is that it?
Right, mister. Matter of fact, I got one of them black Arrow notes myself. That's why I come over to talk to Bill.
Yeah, we've been wondering if this is a little stunt of Craddock's.
Craddock?
Craddock leads the opposition votes, mister. He's a sneaking coyote, if you ask me.
I see. Otto, head for Helena. See if you can locate this man, Craddock. I'll follow you later and meet you at the edge of town, south of town.
Tata savvy. Adios. Get him up.
Now, Donald, ma'am, you too, Henson. I'll tell you about the Black Arrow. I'm sure they're at work in Helena right now. You may find this hard to believe, but that Black Arrow that flew out of the night is the sign of the biggest and worst outlaw band the West has ever seen.
Close that door, Brady. We're all here.
Yeah.
Kino, everybody sit down.
Speak your piece, Craddock.
I got just one thing to say, gents. The Lone Ranger.
Lone Ranger?
Yeah, he's right close by. You tell him, Brady.
Craddock's right, gents. The masked man in the engine must have trailed me and got here. We know because we saw him when we called on Donald to persuade him to change his mind.
All right. So we didn't get very far persuading. Now we got to do more than just talk, savvy?
Craddock, we don't know what your game is, but we're being paid to do what you tell us. We're listening.
Kino, Red. The day after tomorrow in the morning, there's going to be a meeting.
Yeah. The vote on whether Montana has to become a state.
Right. That meeting's already scheduled. It won't be changed. There's 4 votes against our 3. You gents savvy where I'm leading to?
Yeah, but we savvy.
You got to get 2 of those votes out of the way, huh?
Correct, Brady.
Sure they won't change?
After tonight, with the Lone Ranger egging Donald and Hanson on?
Yeah, reckon you're right.
Well, it's up to you boys.
Don't worry, Craddock. We'll get Donald and Hanson tomorrow night and keep them tied up far from town. They won't vote.
All right, Red. That's all, gents. Scatter for now. Tomorrow night, Brady will bring you word where to take them to.
Like you say, Craddock, I caught in thunder.
What's the matter? Why are you staring out of the window?
Thought I saw somebody peering in.
There's nobody there.
I don't see nobody.
Yeah, guess I was wrong. All right, gents. Get out the back way. Talk to you tomorrow night.
Right. Adios.
Adios.
Brady.
Yeah?
Was there someone at that window? With a Lone Ranger around, a lot can go wrong.
No, there couldn't have been. It must have been just a reflection in the glass.
I hope so.
Craddock, why didn't you mention the Black Arrow to Red and the boys?
We're Black Arrow men, but they're not, Brady. They're just bad men on the loose. Pay them, they don't ask any questions. You and me are the only Black Arrow men in on this setup. And we're supposed to keep that as secret as possible. Tell them. Don't be a fool, Brady.
You're a fool too, Craddock.
Torlock!
Torlock, I thought you were heading for the hideout.
I've been there and back, Brady.
Torlock, we were just settling how to take care of this.
I heard you from outside, Craddock. I called you a fool because I wasn't the only one who heard you.
Huh? You mean someone else?
I saw him as he left. An Indian. Indian on a paint horse.
Tonto.
Yes, the Lone Ranger's partner.
He was the one you spotted through the window, Brady.
Yeah. Jumping Mavericks, Torlock.
Yes?
If the engine heard us, that means he knows our plan. That means the masked man will be ready for the boys when they go after Donald and Hanson.
Smart hombre, aren't you, Brady?
What are we going to do? We got to swing that bolt.
Smart, but your brains won't be needed.
Huh?
I've thought of the answer already. Your gang won't go after Donald and Hanson tomorrow night.
Well, that makes sense, Torlock. It's risky.
Yeah, it's too risky.
But what else can we do? Even if the Lone Ranger and Tonto are there waiting for us.
We can do something else, Craddock. Donald and Hanson aren't the only delegates, are they?
Huh?
There are 4 altogether. What about the other 2?
Yeah, Torlock. Yeah, I think I know what you mean.
Meanwhile, Tonto reached the outskirts of the town and met the masked man.
Hi, Kemosabe.
Hi, Tonto. You were successful?
Tonto see Brady. Him with man named Craddock. Tonto here plan. Tomorrow night, gang of men take Donald and Hanson away so they not vote.
Tonto Compan tell you what he find out.
But Tonto did not know that Torlock, a leader of the Black Arrow, had made a change in those plans. Nor did the Lone Ranger know. When the masked man and Tonto rode back to the covered wagon where Donald and Hanson waited...
Masked man, did you find out anything?
Hanson, you and Donald must be ready. Garrick plans to have a gang of outlaws capture you tomorrow night. And to hold you prisoners until after the meeting in the morning.
Mister, thanks for the warning. I reckon with you to help us, we can beat off any outlaw band.
I think we can. We'll be ready for them when they come tomorrow night. Ready and waiting.
And so the next night, Donald and Hanson sat before the fire, apparently alone. Hidden behind the canvas of the wagon top, the masked man and Tonto waited. The men talked in whispers.
Masked man, sure they won't spot your horses?
Silver and Scouter in the dark, Donald. They'll come when they call.
I got a feeling something's wrong. You sure of your facts, Injun?
Time to hear what them say.
The night's dragging on. Nothing's happened yet.
Oh, you're jumping at the moon, Hanson. They'll be alone.
They will, unless they've changed their plans.
Why, sure. It's a plumb line cinch, Hanson. With Sarah sent away so she can't get in the way of any stray bullets, why, I'm looking forward to a gunfight. We sure surprise them.
Where's your wife go, Donald?
I sent her over to stay with Morland and Petrie, mister.
Morland and Petrie? They're the two other delegates who are supposed to vote with you?
Sure, same as a... The way you say that makes me wonder.
I can hear a horse, Donald. Just one horse.
Hmm?
Tonto here now, too.
So do I. Traveling faster this way.
Bill! Bill!
Blazes, it's my wife. Something's up.
Bill! Where's the masked man?
Right here, Mrs. Donald. What is it? Why did you leave Moreland and Petrie?
I didn't leave them. They left me and the wife.
What's that?
I come as fast as I could. Masked man, that Black Arrow outfit tricked you. Instead of taking my husband and Hanson like you figured, they took Moreland and Petrie.
Two boats. Really?
The whole gang headed along the Needle Trail not half an hour ago.
The Needle Trail? You're sure?
Positive, masked man.
Then there's still time. Hello, call Scout. Here's Silver.
Yes, call Masked Man. You going after them?
Yes, Donald. They must be at that meeting by morning.
Well, then we'll go with you.
No, there isn't time. Your horses could never keep up with Silver and Scout. You go to that meeting.
But look here.
Go to the meeting. Got to prevent a vote as long as you can. We've got to get Morland and Petrie away from that gang. Ready, Tonto?
Be ready.
Then after me, the Needle Trail.
Get him up, Scout. Well,
Silver! At breakneck speed, the great stallion in the paint raced through the darkness, cutting across country to Needle Trail. Then, at a word from the Lone Ranger, the horses stopped.
Here. Horse and trail ahead. That must be gang.
Sounds like a dozen at least, Tonto. We'll have to take them by surprise.
And what we do?
Your guns are loaded? The trail slopes upward ahead. It's getting light enough so that we can see them as they top the rise. Morland and Petrie will be tied. They'll be in the middle of the gang. We've got to lift them off their horses and get away before we can be cornered.
That means Silver and Scout carry two riders.
Yes, and they've got our outdistance pursuit carrying double. It's a long chance, but it's the only one. Now after them. Don't gallop until I give the word.
Get away with this, mister. We got a meeting to make this morning. We're delegates to the territory.
You won't make that meeting, mister. I reckon Montana will stay at territory.
Why, you...
Shut up! Keep your mouth closed, Morland. They may not live at all. Your rope turning a steer for Fred and a... What the...
This way! Help!
Like a double bolt of lightning, the masked man and Tonto charged into the surprised outlaws. Before they could gather their wits, the ranger was in their midst.
Morland, Petrie, we're taking you with us.
The rope delegates were lifted from their saddles. Silver and Scout wheeled and galloped headlong, leaving confusion behind them.
Mister, who are you?
Never mind that. We're taking you back to Helena.
Your horses are carrying double.
Our horses can outrun any in the West. We'll get you to that meeting in time. Come on, Silver.
Hit him up, Scout. All I'm saying is we can wait a mite longer. Morland and Petrie delegates to this meeting. If they don't show up...
If they don't show up, it's their own fault. I demand a vote.
It's not their fault. You had something to do with this, Grant.
I'm true, Glatch. I demand the vote.
Yes, vote.
Looks like we're licked, Donald.
Yeah, I reckon so.
All right, gents. Looks like there's nothing I can do any longer to stop a vote. Looks like the will of the people of Montana isn't going to be carried out. Thanks to...
What in thunder? What's that?
Colonel Hanson, the masked man, get us here in time.
Morland. Morland and Petrie, you got here. Gentlemen, call the vote. Montana's going to join the Union, thanks to the masked man.
Look, Craddock. Built your horse to a lather getting out here. The Lone Ranger beat us again, didn't he?
You know about it, Torlock?
Brady told me, Craddock. But don't worry, we can still prevent Montana from becoming a state.
That petition has to go all the way to Washington, remember? And as for the Lone Ranger, look there, down in the valley.
What? The masked man... Him and the engine. But they're heading this way.
Yes, along the trail. They'll be up here in about 3 hours, Craddock. Get an ambush ready for them.
And make sure you don't miss.
Copyrighted feature of the Lone Ranger Incorporated.